Good morning, UCY.TV radio listeners. This is Lonnie Clark with the Age of Fission radio show. Thank you for joining us. Today is September 2nd, 2016. And you know what that means? I think it's been something like 2,005 days since Fukushima has been ignored. And now we have the nuclear industry trying to teach us that it's just normal, perfectly normal to be radiated. Today is Call-In Friday. Let me give you the number right away. The number is 718-717-8296. And I really appreciate you all being with us here. Today on our show, we have two guest hosts, and I hope they're both still with us. We have Dana Durnford and Michael from Primertime. Michael, are you still with us? Dana, are you here?
I am.
Yay. Okay, so Michael, you do know our call-in number. I'm hoping that you will give me a call back, the number 718-717-8296. Dana, thanks for joining us today. I really appreciate you joining us on Call-In Friday. Here he is. There's Michael. Michael, are you with us? Hello? Oh, dear. Well, I can't seem to get him. So, Dana, we have 1 hour and the time flies by. So I really am grateful that you are joining us. Just as a quick reminder, would you remind people how you became kind of a public figure in this whole thing? I mean, when I first found you, you were a YouTube vlogger. And things have gotten much more public since then. Would you please kind of brief people on the journey that you've taken in the last year? Or 2 years. Sure. I guess it's 2 or 3 or 4. Now it's like a super long time. Like, hello.
Yeah, the first year I covered 9,000 headlines about Fukushima. And they were live. You cover 50 to 100, sometimes more, each show. And so we flushed it out really well. And then we went out on expeditions. We've done 5 expeditions, 260 days on the coastline of British Columbia, Canada, from one end right to the other end, and we covered 15,000 miles, a couple of 100,000 pictures, miles and miles and miles of underwater footage. And we disseminated that on the internet at my site, the nuclearproctologist.org. And so we have a very rather long history. Then when I came ashore after 5 expeditions, 260 days on the ocean, I found myself getting arrested. And so I was arrested and vilified and demonized in the mainstream media in Canada for harassing allegedly 2 nuclear scientists or 2 marine chemists. One is Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution and the other one is from University of Victoria, British Columbia, Canada. Now, I'm not allowed to mention their names as part of this hush-hush court order they have against me. This was about demonizing me, vilifying me, and trying to put these people back up on a pedestal. Now, these people are notorious lawyers, and so I called them out, got arrested for it. We're going to court for trial in about 2 weeks after 5 court appearances. The last
What's your possible conviction sentence? Like, what if you got convicted?
10 years in jail.
Lord. Really? And what is the charge? What's the, what are they saying that you did?
Criminal harassment. Criminal harassment. I call it criminal harassment against nuclear puke machines, but it's criminal harassment. This was a law made up for stalkers.
Just last May, actually.
And these are public speakers. These are the 2 biggest public speakers in North America, and you're not allowed to criticize
Jay
them.
I can say their names. It's Jay Cullen and Ken Buesler, and they are from Woods Hole Oceanographic. And what they did, they were out on the ocean testing water, saying, hey, there's just not that much radiation. The ocean's safe, folks, which they know it's disingenuous to test the water because fish is 1,000 times more toxic, at least, because the animals in the ocean.
15,000 times they bioaccumulate it, and shellfish would be 120,000.
I mean, some of them, it goes anywhere from like 1,000 times to 15,000, depending on the species. They need potassium. They need these trace elements.
Sure do.
There's not enough in the water, so over time they have evolved to magnify it by like 1,000 times, so that they can live in the ocean water. And those little creatures identify instead of as potassium, which is what they're magnifying naturally.
And calcium.
Magnify and calcium, they magnify the radiation, the cesium-137, the cesium-1, all of them. And so eating a fish is actually at least 1,000 times more toxic than drinking a gallon of water.
Adult fish would be 15,000 times.
That's right. And these scientists know this, and they are intentionally working to... It's kind of like what's going on in the States here, don't you think, Dana, where we're talking about WikiLeaks exposing the DNC election fraud. We're talking about WikiLeaks leaking instead of the election fraud. You know what I mean? We're not talking about, like, the real issue of the fish is being contaminated.
Now, it's worse than that. Let me jump in, because I didn't finish it off, just that last statement. Was I found less than 100 species left symmetrically throughout the entire coastline when you added them all up.
Wow.
Now, in an average spot, you expect to find over 5,000, 5,600 in the average spot. And other spots like Banfield, British Columbia, would have another 1,800 species more than the average. And I was just up to Banfield 2 weeks ago. Got barred from the Banfield Research Institute. Just as, when they see me coming, they come out and banned me. They knew who I was. I was going to ask them why there was only 14 species instead of 7,200 species I covered that whole coastline. And I've done a 4-hour video showing the video of the coastline in close detail and me driving right into that community with the boat, just so people couldn't say I wasn't there, because that's what people like to do. Oh, Dana wasn't there. But why would I post the GPS and the pictures, 2,000 pictures a day of the coastline, if I wasn't there? You know, how is that possible? And why would somebody do something like that? So it's just the industry trying to trick people and deceive people and seed some doubt and everything else. And these are unrelenting. These people are unremorseful. They don't care about anything, including their own loved ones. It's really something, yeah.
The brainwashing is just complete. I mean, Wendy...
It's something else.
Wendy Lambert was on Wednesday. She lives in Hanford. We were talking... I mean, that was my focus with the interview. Like, because she said she lived in the Tri-Cities. She grew up there. And when she became an adult, she started questioning it. And it was like living in the Stepford Wives. Like, everybody there, if you question it, you're considered, crazy. Literally crazy. I mean, she had to move away. And it is shocking, the secrecy and the lies and the complete lack of concern. I mean, remember, Dana, in 2013, we were being told there's a plume coming to the West Coast. A plume of radiation is going to hit the West Coast. So when the plume hit, it turned into the blob.
Right, a 1,000-mile superheated blob in the
mysterious blob. We have no idea. Oh, it must be La Nina. Let's blame it on the women.
Right.
Once
and
again,
the animals are all dying of a mysterious pathogen or a mysterious virus. But if you look at the Ebola, what was the first thing? They didn't know what it was, but they got pictures of it because it's just a virus. So they took a picture of it, and then they asked scientists, could they identify it, and it got identified as Ebola. But they can't seem to do that with the starfish. They can't seem to do that with the mysterious pathogens or the mysterious viruses. No pictures ever. No descriptions ever. No research laboratory describing it ever. It's just these connotations and these conjectures. So that's not the journalism, that's not science, and that's not real.
They're working really hard. They really do on the media. There was a story yesterday about how the Fukushima reactors, which you did a live stream, I was so grateful that you did, that the Fukushima reactors might restart again. Like, and in the article, the guy said there was a nuclear reactor that had a meltdown. And in the past tense. As soon as I saw your live stream, I dug that article up. I looked at the link, and I literally wrote this guy an email, of which, of course, there's no response. I did, because, like, what the heck? Like, this guy's, I looked into his
Tucker Carlson's outfit, right? The Daily Caller we're talking about, for anybody. He's the White House press club, too, on top of that. Everybody knows who Tucker Carlson is, of course. And so here's
Carlson's the bow tie guy.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Yeah,
everybody knows who he is, whether they like him or not, but they know who he is. And here he is. He's allowing these absolutely unbelievable. I mean, the buildings are completely destroyed. They blew apart. They detonated. They threw the reactor cores something like 3,000 feet straight up into the air at one of them, at Unit 3. This is unprecedented on our planet. Like, Chernobyl was 600 kilometers away from the ocean. Fukushima is right smack on the ocean.
Right.
Right smack there.
It's with a river going underneath the facilities right next to a mountain ridge that actually pours the water underneath the facilities. And how did you like that article? He said something like, what do you call the ice sludge, the failed ice sludge machine? He made some remark about the, you know, around Fukushima, TEPCO actually built, they drilled in the ground and they tried to freeze the ground to keep the things from melting, to keep the radiation from pouring into the ocean. And correct me if I'm wrong, Dana, but what they've really discovered is that it turned the mud into sludge. It did not melt. It did not freeze anything. It turned the mud into sludge.
And it became liquefaction,
And
it
becomes
liquefaction and it's so unstable.
Harmed the foundations of the building.
Like quicksand. It's like quicksand. You turn the site into quicksand, basically.
Yeah.
And it just continues to get worse because you keep pumping water in there. Is Michael out there? Go ahead, Michael. I'm sorry, Lonnie.
Michael, are you with us?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. How you
Yay.
Doing, Dana?
I thought you dropped off. I'm so glad you were.
You know, it was strange. As soon as, like, your song was almost done playing and you were about to give it, my device restarted. So it was just, okay.
Perfect.
That's typical.
I think that's kind of sort of what I'd almost like to touch at conversely with what you're covering. You guys have a lot of, like, nuclear knowledge and everything. And there's not really a whole lot of people out there. I mean, the UCY audience and people may catch this like later on YouTube or in some sort of shared podcast or something probably are now coming to like the realization that something's wrong. And they have to kind of reflect that like in the mainstream media, they are still talking about the ice wall like it's the salvation.
Like
and I've seen one story that showed that the ice wall is not working. And that was it. There's no, honestly, I think that a good percentage of the people think that, like, nuclear energy means that the nuclear power plant sends, like, little radiation through the electric lines into your house, and you plug your TV into the
That's
socket
right.
to feed it off of radiation. They have no idea how it works. It's a massive subject. And
that's true. Well, look, on this subject of this ice wall, here we have a story, August 31st. It's written in theoilprice.com, and it's quoted from this. It's another writer. It's called Zainab Kadawali. I guess they're from a different country. But listen to what it says about the ice wall, and it is so factually incorrect. The New York Times reported, and they reported off of this other person's story, on Monday that the Japanese government has funded a construction of a 320 million block of man-made permafrost, that's what they're calling it, that would continue 100 feet underneath the Daiichi plant to solve the unrelenting flood of groundwater that has been headed into the damaged reactors. The project will stop the leak of radioactive water into the Pacific Ocean, which may continue at low levels to this day, the Times said. That is such false misinformation. The story has come out that the ice wall was a catastrophic failure, total failure.
Well, I mean, if the power goes out, then they're going to lose everything they got so-called contained. But you can't contain rain and snow and everything indefinitely. It's going to spill over. Water will find its way out, even if it did work. But why would you build an ice wall? You built the ice wall because the government would pay for it. If you built a normal wall, TEPCO would have had to pay for that themselves. TEPCO has spent over $800 billion, Canadian, so far, almost $1 trillion so far. There probably is $1 trillion because that was 2015 figures. So this is extraordinary. We're talking about Obama and America is going to spend $1 trillion over the next decade upgrading the entire nuclear arsenal and fleet. Yet here's TEPCO on four buildings that broke down. Now they got 30 million one-ton bags they cleaned up. From that 30 million, that's far. If you put a bag in
and
each truck,
and counting,
yeah.
they're still
oh,
doing
yeah.
it like insane.
It's a tiny fraction.
Ants.
It's a tiny fraction of what they need to clean up. Go ahead, Lenny.
They're like little ants. They just put these things in the bag, stack them in, and they have no regard to what the net result is. It's, to be honest, I mean, I think you're right, Michael. Most Americans have no idea, and our listeners on
you might as well be talking about magic, seriously. I think that in the last 40 years, this population has been dumbed down to where operating Velcro tennis shoes is becoming, you know, something that now not only needs sensitivity training, but also needs safety training. And, you know, you have to consider the ethical implications of the Velcro shoes. You know, I mean, that's what we've been focusing on versus, you know, a little bit of science knowledge that could show you that, yeah, building a gigantic refrigerator underground is kind of like not the answer.
Michael, what part of the country do you live in?
I live on the Gulf Coast of Texas.
Okay, so in your little neck of the woods, do most people, are they aware that Fukushima is still raging out of control and that it is a catastrophic event that is going to, that is affecting the entire planet?
Of most people in my area, no. No. Mm-hmm. They would think that Fukushima was one of the cities we bombed in World War II, or it was some sort of like Japanese food dish, or possibly a Pokemon. They have what Fukushima is. I would say of people I know, the only ones that know something about it would be because I showed them the video of Fukushima blowing up back in, you know, whatever it was, 2011.
Everybody ran away from that reactor when it blew up.
Right, and it's almost surprising to me because I live, all right, so the Gulf Coast of the United States is, you know, the third coast. It's a beautiful place, but it's also kind of like the United States dumping ground. I don't want to go as far as say it's like a toilet or anything, but you can do things down here that you can't do anywhere else. And so there's chemical and petrochemical factories all up and down this area and pretty much all along the Gulf Coast up until you get to about Florida. And
so, Michael, let me
just interject.
Let me interject. Yeah, the whole industry has been predicated upon no rules, no oversight, no checks and balances.
It's not just the industry. It's the entire culture. It's the entire mass consumption culture.
That's a better way of looking at it. But a single melter reactor is worse than every waste on the site, all the catastrophes, all the plastic, all the oil spills, all the chemical petroleum, all the pharmaceuticals released into the ocean. But if you actually look at America, just to back up what you said in that context, was that if you look at the coastline of America, it's nuclear dumps from the 40s, 50s, and 60s just off your coastline. If you look throughout your country...
Let me interject. Not too far from me, there's what is potentially the largest Superfund cleanup site waiting to happen at an Alcoa aluminum factory, you know, a facility. And, it will dwarf the cleanup of all other, of all of them combined. And the only reason they're not doing it is because they keep a skeleton crew on to say that it's actually still open, so they don't have to.
They can't clean up, say, a landfill with nuclear waste in it. They can't clean up Hanford. You would bankrupt the country.
They can't clean it up either.
You can clean it up. You can send in robots and start cleaning up, but you can't do that with nuclear because the robots will die too. Every nuclear
I will tell you this, up in Hanford, they will tell you that they have cleaned up there. They really, those people up there, while their oncology rates are off the charts, they have microencephaly babies all the time. The people up near Hanford in the Tri-Cities will unequivocally tell you. And in fact, I think I've heard many people on the East Coast say, yes, they can't clean up these sites. That's what the whole thing is.
Okay,
let's take one that's
totally been cleaned up. And is kind of like out of commission. And it's not even a nuclear reactor factory. It was making power or anything. Rocky Flats outside of...
It was making the triggers, right. 90,000 plutonium triggers. The leftovers are buried there.
All kinds of accidents, all kinds of...
They've been in litigation now for 40 years or something, and no one's ever won against them.
It was a great big employer to the people of that.
It's 90%.
A single reactor can kill the planet. As simple as that. A single reactor starts off killing your country.
Let's just be clear. Fukushima is killing the planet. I mean, honestly, it is.
Wait up.
Plastic is too big. The radionuclides we're talking about are 1/10,000th, a millionth of a meter. The plastic, the pollution, and stuff like this is much bigger. Many times bigger.
You're talking about
it doesn't assimilate the same way, right? Go ahead.
You're talking about what would you might as well be talking about magic and hokey pokey and miracles and alien stuff, because people have no idea what they're talking about. Now, getting back to Rocky Flats, that place has been closed down. They've done whatever they had to do, the trillion and a half dollar, I think what it was officially, clean up. I mean, it cost building more than that monstrosity airport in Denver. That is now tract homes. They're selling like 3-acre home sites there on the property where that, you know, that had, you know, small nuclear detonations and whatnot.
That's right. Move along. So, move along, folks. It's not going to harm you. It's
right.
Just
the whole
like
country
banana.
Is like that.
It's just insanity. It's beyond.
40, 50, 60.
And I mean, I'm not knocking what you're doing by any means, but I think that you guys know enough of this that you're almost, you have a product that you almost have to preach to the choir, because if you give this to anybody, Joe off the street, which is the audience you want to hit, right? I mean, that's what you want to. That you got to wake up more people, because in the end, you got to have more people than they do.
That's
because
true.
If you have to force your will on somebody,
which is why they're spending so much money on the brainwashing. We have article after article like that one I just cited. New hope for nuclear power in Japan.
It's not just the brainwashing. They have to harass you through legal means. They have to harass you through the police means or something like that. So there's. Honestly, the whole like nonviolent thing doesn't work, because that's exactly what
that's your no that's your playbook, right? They have a playbook, and if you don't know the playbook, playbook's called the Art of War, and everybody uses it throughout the world. But that's your original playbook, and then you can see the extrapolations that they use in the current technology that's available, and so you have to play those exact same rules all the time. You have to be willing to take the beating, to give a little beating. And you have to be willing to learn and understand and be able to dissect
it. Never takes
and articulate it. I do.
The man never.
Yeah, they do. Yeah, they do. Oh, yeah. That's why they arrested me, because they had no choice. That was
the information. And I'm going to tell you what, dude, I totally respect your information, but I have to reiterate this point to almost everybody else out there outside of this small sect of people who actually know what the hell's going on and know what's going what is actually occurring. You're talking about magic. You got nobody knows what you're saying, and I don't mean that in a insulting way or anything.
Well, they
I know
do by the time you listen to the whole stream.
But it's a subject matter that's blowing everybody away.
I agree, look at it this way. That's why I do what I do. That's why I work so hard, is because I understand there's so few people. So generally, I'm targeting the people that want to be active, and so you educate them on how to be articulating and understand what the fables and the follies are. But are you talking about something like 9,000 facets of nuclear? You're talking about a million corporations dependent upon the industry. You're talking about millions of studies where every animal died for 70 years without fail. No animal's ever been cured. And you're talking about, you know, I got 60,000 studies on how it's assimilated into plants and food and water and to every aspect of your life, and how difficult it is to aggregate it out of your body. It's literally impossible, because it becomes sequestered in your muscles, your organs, and your bones, where it mutates the stem cells in your bones. That's why you see these vicious cancer. But generally what happens is there's 1,800 autoimmune deficiencies, illnesses, injuries that'll show up before the cancer. So autism, Alzheimer's, dementia, there's diabetes, heart, liver, lung, respiratory, pituitary, adrenaline gland, pineal gland problems. That'll manifest and be diagnosed and will cause you to liquidate your assets long before the cancer shows up. But cancer will show up in some aspects. Like in Japan, say there's supposed to be 3 out of 1 million children or people would have thyroid. Right now in a study on children alone, there's 13,600. Not out of a million, but out of 40,000.
Well, not only that, Dana. They were underreporting. There's stories that the doctors there are underreporting the thyroid effects.
Stillbirths, stillbirths, and then deformed babies and fetuses. And there was 100,000 abortions after Chernobyl because of these kind of issues.
Okay, so like with stillbirths and stuff like that, now you almost get into something where you can actually push that to the average consumer and even to the beginning.
Diabetes. There's six times more breast cancer around a nuclear power plant. There's double leukemia for children around nuclear power plant within a 15-mile zone. But we should be studying diabetes. You should be studying autism. Right. You should be studying dementia. You should be studying these kinds of autoimmune deficiencies that are well known through the animal studies to show up long before, and human studies. I mean, they gave 800 pregnant women in a Stanford experiment at a hospital. They gave 800 pregnant women what they call vitamin drinks and vitamin shots, but these were americium, neptunium from a chain reaction. That was in the 50s and the 60s. Right. They had carried out many experiments similar to that, by the way, folks, on population that was retired, on senior citizen, that senior citizen home, and school children, feeding them radioactive porridge at orphanages is another notorious study. That has finally been released.
And all of John Goffman's work is just completely ignored. Right. Arthur Tamplin, Dr. Linus Pauling, their work is... I actually heard this... Who was it? It was an interview with somebody yesterday. It was an interview with Jasko. And he said, we just are doing the studies. We've only been studying radiation since the 80s. Now, Jasko said this. The former commissioner of the NRC literally said, well, we're just discovering how harmful radiation is in the 80s.
I played a clip of him 2 days ago of him saying they were getting lethal doses at Fukushima back when it happened.
They know they are.
And I played other people saying it too. They knew back then. See, but then they... Go ahead.
Let me give the number out in case anybody listening wants to call in and ask Dana a question. The number is 718-717-8296. You're listening to Lonnie Clark with the Age of Fission radio show with Dana Durnford and Michael from Primertime, my guest host here on the Age of Fission radio show. So, Dana, you actually have...
Well, Mike makes some great points where nobody understands the topic at all, right? And that it's easy to understand the common stuff like plastic or chemical spills in the community or aluminum factories that have polluted those communities. Like a coal plant, you can live alongside of it for 20 years. You get sick, move away, you'll probably be okay. Drive past a nuclear power plant on the highway, on the way to that coal plant, and suck in one of those radioactive atoms, a single atom. I can put 2 million on a head of a needle, but you can't see it. But you suck that into you got 1,800 diseases will show up, one of them, or 10 of them, before the cancer, 10, 20, 30, 40 years down the road. But it's going to show up because it sequesters in your organs, your muscles, and your bones. It's going to show up for sure. All the studies, every animal would die of multiple tumors, not just a single tumor. Now, we're drinking and eating multiple. We were breathing in California. There was 1,500 radioactive atoms per cubic meter of air, so 9 feet by 9 feet by 9 feet. And this is where you're standing, say, roughly. And so you were breathing in California about 360 particles a day. These are hot particles. Reactor 3 in Japan was 2 million times worse than any other reactor on the planet, but 4,500 times worse than all the reactors combined. And the reason being is they used reclaimed plutonium, reclaimed uranium as fuel. They took that from missiles, and America used to have something like 48,000 missile silos throughout the country releasing radioactivity into those areas all the time. They got all the waste sites throughout the country. These are holding sites, not actual waste sites, not repositories. They don't know what to do with it anywhere on the planet. Some people have buried it on the planet, but that is not the solution, because if it goes into a meltdown, and it will in 10 years or 100 years or 1,000 years, the metals will go, when they touch each other as the stuff decays, and we have a chain reaction happening on the planet deep inside of Earth, and that it will cook at 9,000 degree Fahrenheit temperatures like the sun, and it'll burn indefinitely. Now, we normally attack it with boron, which is a way of stopping a neutron dividing, and so we can't do that when it's down into, like, what happened at WIP, a waste repository in America. They put it all underground, 55 football cavern-sized, football field-sized containment areas. They had a truck fire, allegedly, and then they abandoned 55 football fields. They didn't get on the other side of the truck and put it out. They abandoned 55 football fields, but 10 days later, they claimed they had a radiation release in another section. They hadn't went back down to that mine, so they had lied about everything. Now, they can't, like, I came out with a video, and TV attacked me right away with it, showed clips of me and said I was like a kooky guy. But I said, you'll never get back down there, and it'll take, if you do, you'll spend billions and billions, and they have in the last couple of years. And they still can't get down there, and they keep claiming they can. But no, the whole place is coated with radioactive material. It's a death sentence. Now, think about it. I'll end it on that, Michael, and let you jump in. Your suit will protect you from radioactive particles, but this material is gamma shine. It's neutron beams. It's X-rays. It's beta emitters that are very powerful. It'll go through bricks and walls and everything else. And so your little tiny suit, same as at Fukushima, same as at Hanford, same as at any nuclear site on the planet, is not protecting any of them. You can't protect them. You got to worry. Look at the people in Chernobyl. They dressed themselves in handmade lead suits, right? They drilled a hole in thin lead, and they wrapped their bodies in it and ran around the roof for 20 seconds and then went home, never went. And he died usually a couple of weeks later. There were 600 helicopter pilots died at Chernobyl. That's that you won't right. see at the UN site.
Well, not only that, they Go ahead, deny Mike. That it happened.
Well, yeah, like absolutely. I mean, that's kind of what the main thing is. Who's making that sacrifice? Because, I mean, like, the Russians threw, like, what, like 650,000 people or something like that at Chernobyl over, like, 10 years?
Right.
I mean, like, initially it was, like, 350,000, and then, like, another 300,000 went in and cleaned
it's
up.
It's conscripted 600,000 soldiers right away, but another 400,000 tradespeople. Kofi Annan said there was 3 million children from disabilities.
That's right. I mean, one of the things we're getting aware of, though, is the radioactive contamination along the entire northern hemisphere. Look at all the nuclear power plants in Europe. Look at all the, not just the power plants.
And there's studies showing how that comes into the community from the ocean with the fog and with the rain and how cancers and autoimmune deficiencies increase in those areas. When they shut down 2 nuclear power plants around in America there a number of years back, the first thing they noticed was a decrease in infant mortality.
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
Because these places are releasing it constantly, venting it out of those big stacks. It's just the stupidest thing imaginable what they're doing in the community. They shouldn't be on the planet, let alone in the community.
Well, this is the thing. This is the issue. And, you know, Michael can attest to this. Around our country, people – I actually heard this new phrase recently. We're called nukemongers, Dana.
Good.
Instead of good, yeah, good. Thank you. Because we
tell a friend.
Yeah, exactly. Because really, the reality is, this is really the most dangerous thing on our planet, and we're in the stew. I mean, the denial. They spend more money denying. You can go.
One
online.
Can kill a planet. We got 4 melted down in Japan. Yeah, one can kill a planet.
But we're spending $70 million on high school football stadiums. This doesn't mean anything to anyone.
Well, it might not now, but it will. It will in a couple of years. You can't get away from it. You can't hide it. You can't ignore it. You can't pretend it didn't happen. You can't pretend it won't affect you. You can't, because look at the Techo River where they evacuated 7,500 communities. But also look at the Philippines. Look at Tonga. Look at Fiji, look at Vanuatu, look at Mexico. Look at these were all in the Pacific Ocean, all experienced in the last couple of years, storms in excess of 200 miles per hour without losing speed after passed through their country. We've seen the Philippines lost 41 provinces. It leveled it. It took 30 million coconut trees and turned it into projectiles, gusting at 225 miles per hour. We get that wind on our coastline, we're done. That'll knock down, that'll be the big bad wolf. It'll knock down everything flat. You won't be able to, like in British Columbia where it's all trees, you won't be able to drive on a highway for years if a storm like that comes through. You'll never be able to clean it out because every community will be chock full of it. But not only that, you will level every building in British Columbia if we get hit on this coast with that kind of wind. And we've never seen this on this planet before. That's because you look at the ocean, a glass of water should have a billion creatures in a glass of salt water. Now, the extinction event we see playing out in the Pacific is all the animals are starving to death. We've seen 500,000 MERS, common MERS, that can dive up to 600 feet, just starve to death up the coastline several months ago in Alaska and British Columbia. We've never seen anything like that before. They never had parasites. They never had diseases. They never had infections. They never had illnesses. They never had injuries. They starved to death. But what was really interesting about those studies was that in their tracks of their throats and that, they didn't even find the microscopic animals. And so a glass of salt water, look at it this way, a glass of salt water has a billion creatures. If you dip your finger into that glass of salt water, you're going to bring out several hundred creatures. So a bird does the same thing because he's dipping his beak underwater all day looking for food. And he swims in that environment. They didn't even find that in his feathers, the tracks, the microscopic world. So this is why the pictures of the coastline are naked, is because the 4.2 million other species that are also in the ocean were wiped out also. We've seen the squid are gone, the herring are gone, the anchovies are gone, the krill is gone. the migratory birds are gone. I counted 11 species out of over 300 species. Over 30,000 insects, I only counted around 30 species. And out of the highly visible species, I only counted less than 100 species out of the 5,600. But there's 6,500 invertebrates without the backbones that would be living in tandem. So in your tidal zones, you would have 600 species of algae. And that's where those 6,500 invertebrates would hide away from the sun and the harshness when the tide goes out. But at the same time, the migratory birds, the animals, the coastline animals in particular, would be dependent upon those zones, those tidal zones, like they have been throughout millenniums. Now, to top it all off, you got to think about when I done the whole coastline for 260 days, I'm looking at the Rocky Mountains. And now it takes 5,000 years for that ice pack that is now missing to come back. Now, nobody's reporting on that. But that ice water that's missing from the mountains, this is why you can't ignore it anymore, because the water's ice is missing from the mountains. That would regulate your streams, your estuaries, your rivers, your coastline during drought and during summer times and stuff like that. That is a natural way of life. It will take 5,000 years for that cycle to reboot, if it ever reboots. That's because the tritium doesn't allow the ice to crystallize, and until that is gone, you won't have ice there. So it'll be about a billion years.
Tritium, because
it's the combination in the water.
I wondered about that, because we had read that the ice in Greenland is melting faster than anything they had ever predicted.
That's 3,200 polar bears in the Antarctic starving to death.
I know.
Right?
Well, yeah. There's a YouTuber who actually
we've never seen nothing like this.
The Alaska recreational thing, and she catches every once in a while, she'll find you her last video on this bear. It was so sad. It was like too weak to actually, there was no fish in the stream. There was no salmon going upstream, and he's standing there super weak, just like wobbling over trying to find something. It was really sad.
I went right up to seals, literally nose to nose taking pictures, and I told Terry to back away. I couldn't look at the seal. I couldn't look it in the eye anymore. And I put those pictures up on my website. The seal was destroyed. Its skin, its fur is destroyed. Its body is destroyed. They never even tried to get away from me. I've never seen this.
Give your website address so that people can go.
TheNuclearProctologist.org. You got to put TH in front of it. TheNuclearProctologist.org. And so my job is basically self-imposed to dissect a nuclear narrative, back it up with the documentation, the information, the peer-reviewed studies. So you can't call someone a lawyer until you can prove they're a lawyer definitively. It has to be proven definitively. But I've done this 1,000 times now. And so I put that stuff up on the internet. 300 of those videos I had to take down with a court order. But while I was in jail for 12 hours, ghost accounts took down two videos that I was accused of making salacious remarks. These were political hyperbole, where you make a remark where you think someone should be hung. Now, they tried the year before two different times to have me arrested, the same people. Then they stacked those up for 2015. I was still on the ocean. I was gone for 5 months at one stretch. And then I've done the final expedition on the West Coast only, the open ocean. I took an incredible, inconceivable amount of beatings doing this whole thing. But the West Coast was the most terrifying thing imaginable. I spent times when I couldn't eat for 24 hours. It was so rough, with three beach lines and the anchor line with cannonballs on it, trying to hold my boat, hit away, can't get out of there, nowhere to hide. But we have to do this job. We've done every 20 miles of the coastline, right from Alaska all the way down to the other end of Canada. And this was relentless, obsessive, that I had to see the whole coastline and document it in 1,000 pictures or 2,000 a day, and underwater footage and bird counts and insect counts. And so when I say you can't ignore what happened and what's happening and what's going to happen, that's what I mean. You can't ignore it, no matter who you are, how dumb you are, or how ignorant or incompetent you might feel you are. You're not. You can learn any and all of this easily. That's the point of what I do. Right now I'm creating a 10-video series that starts off with the entire history of nuclear right back from the beginning, and that'll educate people on their own. And before I even talk about Fukushima, I'll do 10 videos in a series. I'll be selling them at my site, or they'll be up on the internet for free, I'm sure. And I'm not going to restrict it. And I don't restrict. Everything I got is free. Everything on my website is free for everybody to go make documentaries and monetize it. And that you can find more of my material at the Beautiful Girl by Dana on YouTube, Beautiful Girl by Dana. You'll connect over from my website with those videos. You'll get to my site. And you'll find video presentations where I use the most elaborate software imaginable, the most incredible equipment imaginable to tell you that story in a one-hour presentation, or just a one-hour screaming fit who knows what the mood is going to bring today. I mean, last night, I had to do a stream last night because some idiot, some moron in journalism has got everybody out there saying, oh, they're going to restart the reactors in Japan. And I can't just sit there and allow that to happen for another hour or minute. I had to come out.
Okay, but see, this is where it is, dude. They are gonna tell the lies, and they are gonna shut you down at every point.
That's right.
They
can't.
Not anymore. It's not even started, man. I mean, honestly, no, you're still alive.
You're still alive. They can kill me. It don't matter. I have 1,000 videos on the internet that tells each one of them tells that story. And that people will be able to rally from that knowledge, right? Go ahead.
From being a race. I mean, I don't mean that in a bad way.
You're in the same boat.
I'm fully aware of it, man.
That's just PR firms. Always don't mind them. It's PR firms. That's all.
I'm fully aware of it. But what I'm saying is this has to stop. The information you gave is number one overpowering and it's damning to anybody who puts any kind of brain to it, but it has to stop. And honestly, if you're getting a lot of harassment and whatever you consider harassment, I mean, honestly,
constantly under attack, constantly under siege.
You haven't been beat up and your car hasn't been run off the road.
Yes, he has been challenged and threatened. I mean, Dana's...
Physically, and then I've been... My vehicle on the way down to court, I didn't make it to court. I almost died on the highway. The back tire almost came off. Wow. Yeah, no weird stuff has happened to me at all. My boat was slashed and I almost drowned.
If you can do the math on this and you can see that you're in danger for your information...
Yeah, they're going to kill me. I don't doubt that at some point. That's why I say I got 1,000 presentations out there, even though they took down 300 on my site.
Well, they're killing him, too. I mean, this is the other thing. They put out
demonizing
lies
the media nonstop.
And then just straight journalists even alternative journalists have, like, taken information of these lies and just repeated it like a frickin' parrot. It's so outrageous. I mean, but the denial, see, this is the one thing they can't do. They can't deny the death it's causing. It is.
They don't have to deny the death it's causing because they don't have to talk about it. They'll give you more football. They'll give you more celebrity on dope.
They'll do that for a while. That's the original, Michael, but it won't last forever because the death of the insects, the death of the Pacific coastline, the animals, the marine life, the birds, the fauna and the flora. No, you got the 3 billion people on the planet dependent upon that. That's 50% of the oxygen on the planet on top of that. That is the basis of the food chain, the oxygen, and the carbon sequestering chain. We can't ignore it, and the way it's manifesting is why I say that. Go ahead.
There's like 40 million people killed during World War II. And honestly, World War II, when you get down to it, was a great big fight against the money system. If this is the absolute control, I mean, beyond the money system, because the money system is everywhere. This is end-all, be-all control. Protesting doesn't do anything. Educating people doesn't do anything because they're going to kill half the planet.
Yeah, it's an ecocide and a genocide. This is they're allowing it to carry on like it is because they feel they'll lose complete control and trust and that there'll be pandemonium and chaos and like all the Hollywood predictions, right? I don't think we live in that society anymore. I think that animal instinct is still there, obviously. And like, we're privileged. I'm in Canada, so I don't speak for the whole world, obviously. I'm way too privileged. Even compared to America, I'm extraordinarily privileged. I don't have to lock my doors. I can walk down the street. Nobody's going to accost me. No one's going to go into my house.
Okay, so now you're getting at another why people can't handle what you're saying or maybe
right.
Don't hear.
That's why I try to educate them.
Well, our media is full of that. And honestly, it does happen. I wouldn't want to live in an inner city area in a big, you know, in a big place that's, I don't know, over 500,000 people. I wouldn't want to live down there. It's not safe for that in the United States. But, I mean, this is just like, yeah, it's the end-all event probably in all actuality once it's unstoppable. And... I mean,
just in 5 years. Go ahead, Mike.
Well, okay, just in 5 years, but I mean,
it's amazing. See? Yeah, why I say this acceleration. That's the problem. Yeah, you can't avoid it. You can't avoid those supercell storms either. We've never seen them on the planet before. We've seen them in mountain passes where there's 200 miles an hour wind or something like that in adverse conditions, but we haven't seen it where it's 100 miles wide, takes out the Philippines, 41 provinces, goes across the Pacific and slams into Vietnam and doesn't lose much speed. It never lost any speed going through the Philippines. And these numbers are, we see it on Discovery Channel where they talk about Mars might be like that 200, 225 mile an hour winds, and people were like big, huge destruction paths. We actually had that on our planet in the last couple of years. All of these were in the Pacific Ocean. That's the only spot we saw it. But that's because we killed it, and that the radiation doesn't stop creating energy. It's just going to get hotter and hotter at an accelerated pace. And so when the typhoons and everything are picking this stuff up to become supercharged, because the typhoon is pulsing every second like a perpetual machine. But think about radioactive isotope. If I put it in your body, I can read it with a Geiger counter, certain types of Geiger counter outside your body, because it's pulsing right through all your DNA, your bones, your organs, your muscles, every second out to the Geiger counter. See? And so in the storm, it's the same way, but it doesn't have those restrictions of muscles and fat and bone and everything else and liquids and stuff. And so in the ocean, it still does that. So everything, even if it's not ingesting it in the ocean, is being pounded with it. And the first things we see happen with that is sperm gets destroyed. And because humans take so long to reproduce and see generations down the road, if you look at Fallujah in Iraq after the Iraq War, you know, in Iraq War, they fired 5.5 million rounds a month for 9 years to get 10,000 bad guys. 5.5 million rounds a month, just 1 month to get 10,000 people, would seem pretty stupid. But 5.5 million rounds every month for 9 years, what does that say about us?
Cha-ching. Well, I mean, that's cha-ching. Called war profiting.
Millions dead, millions about. Missing, millions in refugee camps.
It's beyond war profiting.
But anyway,
it's all
Fallujah,
about killing somebody who's got the opportunity to upset the apple cart. That's the whole idea behind the war. It's, they already make all the money. They make all the nukes. They make the guns for both sides. The idea is to eliminate the best and brightest of the plebe class so
guess
they do
it.
Not
they,
threaten the apple cart.
They use
honestly,
uranium.
Absolutely. They use whatever they can, dude. They use whatever they can. They'll burn you. They'll shoot you twice.
84% of the children born in Fallujah were just lumps of flesh because they had used so much depleted uranium there. This was a known fact that they had used 700 tons in...
How do you stop this?
I mean, it's all made
that's really the end of it, the end all be all of this.
Oklahoma.
But wait up, man.
Bombs. Go ahead.
How do you stop this? That's the problem. If there's who is behind it? Who is in charge of it? Who pushes the button that says if this nuclear plant goes online and, you know, and then at that point, honestly, protest all you want. There's 2,000 guys that work at it. Protest all you want. There's 2,000 guys that work at that nuclear plant that have to pay for their new Tahoe and their bass boat and their kids' autism treatments and whatever else they have to do that they can't put it together.
Well, they get double wages.
The American people need like something a little more to akin to like slapping a screaming child. This is.
Well, you can't, like you say, you can't give up just because it seems insurmountable. You can't walk away because it seems
daunting. No, you can't. You have to analyze what you seriously have an opportunity to do. And there's really, well, honestly, let's just say they said, okay, here's the keys to every nuclear plant and weapons facility storage and all that in the country. What do you do? You still need to, like, they're still going to run. You can't just go in there and turn them off. It's a huge entire process that brings in more people. That's not the way.
Insurmountable. We got it for life, Michael. You're right. We got it for life. You can't get rid of it. You can't throw it away. You can't put it on the moon. You can't stick it out somewhere else. We don't have that right to do that anyway. Well, we do produce 4,340 peer-reviewed academic studies daily here in North America, and that would turn some of the horsepower there into coming up with solutions. If we were to get rid of the GMO and then encourage everybody and give everybody free seeds, organic seeds, and let them plant that throughout the community, it would sustain the animal kingdom what's left. It would help foster
seeds,
future
bacteria. They try to eat them thinking bacteria. They were like corn nuts or something, man.
We're looking at
you're dealing with like a population that's dumbed down. They got no
it
idea
is only
what you're
at
saying.
The crux of our if we seen a meteorite coming at us, what would we do? Would we all just bow our head and say frig it, or would we try to stop it? Would we rally this planet? That's what I'm saying. I mean, if we had an alien attack, would we rally the planet? Yes.
That's
what I'm hoping anyway.
You can't stop it. There is no stopping any sort of.
But you try, right? Well, you don't know. You can't stop it or change it.
This is what I think. I think we have to face it so that we can create the solutions. Right now, we have nothing but 70 years of denial. So we have 70 years of not only denial, but being like a 2-year-old, smearing this shit all over the walls, all over the crib, everywhere. And they have never once acted like adults and said, this is a really serious issue. We have to figure it out. And that is what I believe we're going to... We will have this. We are going to have a mass movement where billions of people on this planet are going to be in shock and horror in less than 10 years going, we need money to stop with the wars and start figuring how to save the shreds of what we have.
Well, we don't send our children. Like, we just, it's an educational thing where we're indoctrinated with this machine. But think about, like, I look at the world my way, I guess. Like, if I'm driving down the road and I see a terrorist gunning down all kinds of people, I'm just going to run him over. I don't give a fuck about him. I'm going to run him over. I'm going to get out and piss on his head. I don't give a fuck about him. I'm not going to wait for the police to show up and solve that issue. I'm going to smack him into a side of a building at 60 miles an hour. He's not going to be hurting anybody ever again. Problem solved. I'm not going to be indoctrinated to run and hide and cower and pretend that only somebody with a suit on and a gun on their hip can solve an issue when anybody driving by could have solved the friggin' issue. And then have that used now to demonize everything on the planet. And like you say, it's people like myself and people like you who are willing to speak out and have an opinion and have an educational, informative broadcast that will make the difference ultimately. But that's what we got, and that's all we got, but it's not insurmountable.
Right. And it's enough. We are enough, Michael. I agree. I mean, yeah, it seems huge.
Well, absolutely,
but
we're enough. We're 99.9% of the planet. Absolutely, we're enough. But we had there's one message that really destroys this all, and it's this false concept of nonviolent revolution. And that's the biggest joke.
I
got arrested for that.
Said today, from just the information that's come out today, if this was like translated into a fashion that people can understand and they get a grasp of how this whole thing works and what's going on, there is blood knee deep in the streets tomorrow. And actually, probably not that much blood because there's not that many of them. But
that's right. There are not the.
That's
and
the
what we
original
need is
reaction.
Conscientious
yeah.
objectors.
You settle down after a while, though.
Well, we need conscientious objectors. We need people to refuse to work for Raytheon. We need the scientists to refuse to lie about the facts. I mean, the secrecy. I saw a story this morning about some guys in Utah.
Huh? But look how much Raytheon pays and what you can buy with that. And I mean, it's even deeper than just this, the nuclear stuff. You know, it's the consumer culture. It's Christ. It's worse than slavery. I mean, for us, it's worse than slavery. At least if you were, you know, you were back
have two roads, right?
They had to feed you and clothe you and give you some sort of medical care and provide for your entertainment in the off hours and whatever. Now you have to pay for all of that. And you're too busy worrying about.
That's right.
Honestly,
yeah. And this is the original. I went through these emotions originally, Mike. You remind me of me originally, 100%, where you feel, you know, there's so many ways that you can't break through. But what I decided to do was go ahead and break through. And so I've been at this steady for several years. And I took it to extremes where I went and done 260 days on the ocean, you know, on my own. And originally I had 3 people on the coastline. I gathered up enough people and enough money to go do it. And it was a daunting challenge. It seemed impossible. It's insurmountable. But yet, I done it. And that is up at my website, published already. Not all of it, but the majority is up there. The most important parts of it are certainly up there. And I broadcast it. Now, I do presentations pretty regularly. And it's been a rough year for me, coming off the ocean, getting arrested, and everything else that followed. But I'm still producing these presentations. And anybody can study that presentation, that documentary, 1-hour documentaries for 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, and they will understand all the basics. And over time, over months, a couple of months, your brain is able to handle it, is able to coordinate it, and you become part of that. And that's all it really takes. Look, remember what happened Rupert Murdoch.
Yeah, but okay. So let's say everybody's educated about it. There's still the people who well,
mom
do
and
this.
Dad works there. That's right. Mom and dad works there. You're going after their family members, their friends, their neighbors, their communities, their social networking environment. And so you have to indoctrinate that part of the environment so that their own loved ones turn on them, their own friends turn on them, their own neighbors turn on these people in the right way, in an educational way, where they say, hey, you told me it was like a banana. Turns out every dog died for the last 70 years in every study at Loveless Respiratory Research Institute in New Mexico. And it's just these simple sentences that you bark at these
people.
That's absolutely
the most ineffective manner to get anything solved. You just mentioned.
Oh, that's the only one left.
No, there's not. That's not the only one left. That's the only one left if you follow the damn rule book, dude. The rule book was meant to keep you in line.
This is not, Michael.
I think people should.
Go ahead, Mike.
And it's not just this issue. This issue feeds into everything else. There's no escaping none of this. None of this. These people who own these massive nuclear corporations, Exelon and GE and everybody who does all this, look what else they run. They run prisons. They run they run food companies that poison everybody. And if you think that there is no other thing,
you take
but,
down the head of the snake, the whole snake falls.
You take down the whole damn thing in a fashion that makes the Indians of the Old West
you take
drool.
Down the head. You take the head off the animal, and then the animal falls down. That's what we're looking at. Nuclear is the head of the animal.
Michael, here you are again, advocating violence.
I'm advocating the only thing that works, and that's why it.
I hear you, man. No, I hear you. I'm just
look seriously.
They'll come arrest me. They'll be on my door in 30 minutes.
They will come and arrest you, Dana. You can't talk like that in Canada, Michael. That's exactly what Dana did, and he got charged with aggravated assault. That's an illegal act in Canada.
You know who I am.
I have to call this to an end. We have 30 seconds left.
Good show, though. Enjoyed it.
I hope that we can repeat this. Michael, you're a great guest host. So are you, Dana. I hope you guys will join us. Because,
you
bring an element into this that is just so not me. And
reminds me of me
it.
When I was younger.
I love it. So we have 20 seconds left. Please go to thenuclearproctologist.org. Look at the work that Dana Durnford has sacrificed himself to do. And please do listen to Primertime on UCY.TV. Very interesting. I do listen to it, although I don't understand a lot of it. Put your courage feet on, take some action, and thank you for joining us.